Hi guys, in this video we're going to be doing some work on the new desk. I've already got one of the uprights built, as you can see. I've just got another three of those to build, but I've only got enough bits cut ready to do another two. I've got some of the shelving parts over there cut already. I've got the uprights to cut behind me. But because I need to cut one of the uprights to be the same length as one of these, the upright is actually wider in that direction. Wider. I don't know why I said that. You should know what the width is. Oh well, never mind. I'm having a dirt moment. Anyway, So what I'm going to do, I'll go downstairs with my handsaw, get everything cut to length, and I think it's two pieces that have got to be trimmed down. One piece to be the same width as this, the other to be the same width as that shelf. And I will take those over to Mum's Sunday and just get my stepdad to run them across his table saw. And I think that will be it. So I figured, as I've got the parts, I might as well make a start. I went out and I bought a pack of these to go along the bottom. I don't think it really needs to be there, but by the time I get the shelves screwed in, it's going to be pretty strong. I mean, it's a bit flimsy as it is because it's, you know, two pieces side by side. But, like I said, by the time I get the shelves screwed in, like that, you know, it's not going to be as flimsy. So, three of those per end. And once I've got these two bits made, it would just be a simple task of dropping the two pieces for the top straight on top of it. Should snake my way back behind you. Ooh. I got a bag of six of these. 99p they were, so not that bad actually for six, I didn't think. Even though they are just plastic blocks with holes drilled into them. Three holes drilled into them. Mind you, they are countersunk as well, which is a good thing. So, I am going to crack on. I'm going to put my fan on because it is rather warm today. In fact, I'm get up, you bastard. Go on. Yeah, there we go. I must get a can of WD-40 to try and free that up. There is no adjustment on that bit. Let's get that window open. The swivel mechanism on that, there's a clamp to adjust it. So I can lock it into place if I wanted to. But the up-down, there's no adjustment like that. So it's rather bloody stiff. Right. Last night, just before I go, I did a bit of shopping. Spent more money than I actually wanted to, but I decided to get that train base and the controller from the same eBay seller. Just makes life a bit easier, because I was looking on that Bricklink website and there's just hundreds and hundreds of countries to choose from, and none of which were actually in Britain. Cannot get that controller in Britain for some reason. Umpteen countries and sellers from abroad, USA, Netherlands, France, Belgium, Germany, you name a European country. There's probably other countries, but I didn't look through all the pages because I was just page after page after page. selling this controller. Not one in the UK, because I did a separate search for UK only. Nothing came up. So, I just for the ease, I went to the same German seller on eBay and just purchased both. So I've just got to wait for those to arrive. Then I thought I'll treat myself to some, or, well, it was going to be one My Little Pony plushie. Turned out to be two. Because I found a seller in China selling the Ollie Factory plushies. One was £12 and some odd pence, and the other was £10 and some odd pence. Free shipping. I'm a bit sceptical, as it's from China. But the seller has 100% positive feedback on eBay, and it does say in his listing to give it 25 days. If it has not arrived within 25 days, they will refund you. So I thought, well, if they don't arrive, I can always contact them and say, hey, look, it's been 25 days, it hasn't arrived. Can I have me refund that you promised, please? Simple. So I thought, yeah, if it doesn't arrive, I'll just ask for the refund. Like I said, it's got 100% positive feedback, so I can't complain. And if they do keep to their word, you know, and actually refund you if it doesn't arrive, I actually think that's wrong in a sense, because if it's a fault down to the mail system, you know, if that got lost in the mail, then to me it should be the mail service that refunds you. Or at least refunds the person that sent it. Because they haven't kept to their end of the contract, have they? You know, they failed to deliver your parcel. I don't know. Either way, it just seems that us public, you know, we get bleeding penalised whatever we do. It's always us that ends up being penalised by these big corporations. You know, for example, I've had my local council, who pays my housing benefit, they've penalised me for them overpaying me. I didn't do anything. I've not done a thing to make them overpay me. But for some reason they've ended up doing that twice, and then deduct that from, you know, my benefit. So I have to make up the shortfall. Which is just, it's dumb in my opinion, because it's their fault. You know, they should pay more attention to what they're doing. But anyway, just I'm ranting. I don't want to rant in this video, not really. So I apologise for that. I'm going to pour my drink. I think, no, I'll wait, I'll do that later. I was going to say I might go downstairs and just cut this other wood, but the sun is in the wrong position and it's beating right down out front there where I've got to cut the wood, so I might just leave it another hour or two, let that area out front get shaded by the tree, and it'll be a bit cooler out there as well, because it's a lovely day out there. I'm not complaining. It's lovely, it's sunny, it's beautiful, it's not pissing it down with rain, so it's just, it's a bit hot in the sun when you got to do some work, and I'm not good with that. I don't mind relaxing in the sun, but working in the sun, you know, when I start sweating my tits off and whatnot, I just don't like sweating. But, yeah, I'm actually watching I had a video playing in the background of someone converting a road bike from the drop-down handlebars that racing bikes have to a straight bar. And that's actually given me an idea as to what I might do with that project in the bedroom. That's when I sort the back wheel out, because I've got the back wheel to fit, but because the frame wasn't designed to take a freewheel wheel. When I clamp the quick release axle down, it's actually just jammed the wheel up. The freewheel won't rotate. I can roll it backwards, but I can't roll the bike forwards. So I can get around that. That's not an issue. It just means I still need to adjust the frame and adjust the spacing with the wheel a bit more. That's all. And people are wondering, are going to be wondering, is it really worth it for an old piece of crap? Well, I'm bored and I like to build things, so I think that's the route I'm going to take. I'm not going to turn it into a road bike, I'm going to turn it into a hybrid. I've got the handlebars, I've got the drop, you know, the racing bike brake levers, but I'm not sure I've got the brackets to actually mount them to the handlebar, which would be a setback for a little while till I could get some. So if I make it a hybrid, I've got the brake levers there, I've got shitloads of ordinary brake levers in that box that I really need to sort of use up anyway. The same with gear shifters, I could just put on a pair of ordinary old style, you know, mountain bike click 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 gear levers. Actually don't even have to be click ones. I'd probably sell it when it's done. I don't think I'd keep it. Is it suitable for men and women? Ooh. If you're happy to swing your leg over the bike, yeah. You know. I don't actually know how to reply to that yet. If someone's interested in the Peugeot and they want to collect it, but they want to know if it was suitable for men and women, but yeah, if a woman's, you know, wearing jeans and they're happy to swing their leg over the frame, then yeah. I wouldn't recommend it in a skirt though, because you might get tangled up, or a dress. Oh, right, well, I'm rambling now and I need to get things done, so I will talk to you all in a little while. Well, there's the finished article-ish, kinda, sorta. I say kinda, sorta, because I haven't screwed that bottom plank in yet. But, it's there. It's not perfect. I mean, it was rocking on that far corner, but it's not doing it now. Maybe leaving it sat there has actually allowed it to settle a bit and it's gone to shape. But other than that, I made a few boo-boos myself. I made a boo-boo on that panel. I built it round the wrong way and I've got the wrong bracket right at the top there, which is no biggie, because the outer panel, which will be this one, because this one will be going up, if I just roll around. What have I just knocked into? Oh, a bit of wood. We'll be going up that corner. So this side with the big bracket on will be closest to the wall. Well, the way I've made that one over there would mean the one with the big bracket is actually the inside piece. I don't want it that way around. It doesn't really matter, but I don't want it that way around. Besides that, the metal bracket would actually be on the wrong side anyway, because if you notice, I've put the smaller one on the inside. Or on the outside, I should say. But I need one more of those cut out of probably this bit here, and I need one more of these cut probably also from that piece actually, because I've only got one bit left, so I can't actually make the other cabinet up, you see. So what I'm gonna do, I was gonna measure it, but I might as well just draw around that bloody thing on this. And the same with that one, because if you notice, if I line this up with this, I'll do it the others. See, it's a little bit too wide. Actually, in fact, I don't know whether to take that to my mum's now and get stepdad to do it or not, because that is actually perfect with the groove here where the back panel sat, which means I could actually run my sod it. Can't be asked. What I will do, I've got to go outside and just put my tools away anyway, they're still sitting on the top of the trailer. I will just draw across here with a pencil, cut across that outside, and then do another one the same length as one of those panels, and take those over to Mum's on Sunday and just get stepdad to run the table saw up the edge. Now if I just tell him I want this groove bit just gone, then he'll just run the saw up that for me. And that will solve that problem, and I can bring them home, and on Monday I can get the next part done. And cut the two tops. I might cut the top tomorrow so it's done and dusted, because I've got to cut across there, haven't I? Which actually isn't too bad with the saw I've got. It's actually quite sharp. But again, I just don't fancy cutting that way. Not with a handsaw. Not when I might as well just... If I'm feeling up to it tomorrow, I might give it a go, but I'd get a better cut with the thing. If they weren't so long, I'd have just taken down the measurements I needed, taken a plank to Mum's, but I might as well cut them in half myself. And what I could do, so I was going to say I needed to cut. No, actually I can still work it out, that's alright, never mind. Never mind, screw that. I'm just going to open the tripod up, as I'm moving you around on the tripod. Figured that was easier than just keep taking you off it and putting you back on it. And there we go. I've got the fan going. Right. A few things I need to bring upstairs. But someone on the Regenerate North Walsham group was actually having a bit of a rant because they looked up NatWest Bank's opening times for the branch in town on Google. They just typed it into Google, and at the top of the Google search it said they're open till 5, but they're not. They're actually open till 4:30. So lesson number one: don't take what the actual search result says for granted. Then further down in the comments I was reading, and I literally wanted to just go, because this other woman had put, I checked their website last week to see if they were open on Saturday, and it said till 12:30, but when I got there at 10:30, they were closed. And she included a screen cap, wasn't of their website at all, it was a fucking Google search. The Google search results. So she hadn't actually checked their website. And I'm like, really? You don't know the difference between a friggin' website and a Google search? Blimey. And I just said randomly in the comments, you know, that these days you can do almost, keyword there, almost everything bank related online. And then someone replied, how do you pay cash and checks into a bank account online? And I was like, that's why I said almost everything and not everything. And I also said some ATMs nowadays will allow you to pay cash and check in. And the same person also said, but NatWest's one doesn't allow you to do that. And that's what I thought, well, that's why I said some. I wasn't saying NatWest's did, and I wasn't saying you can do everything online. You know, that's why I put a few keywords in there. Gee. It's no wonder we get called country bumpkins in Norfolk. Jesus. Yeah. I forgot to get your cat food as well. I don't think he'll need any till morning though, but... yeah. Anywho, the last segment for this video will be a bit of a show and tell, so I will see you when I've brought the items up to show and tell, because I'm sitting downstairs at the minute, so talk to you in a bit. Well, I'm back for the final part. Discord's timing is crap, isn't it? Don't know if you heard that. Anyway, I've got some goodies up here that, believe it or not, the whole lot cost me £11. I'm going to start with this. It's a turntable. An AWA branded one. It does say works, needs a needle, and I have checked there is no needle. Needle, stylus, whatever you want to call it. Oh, this has a size selector on it as well. But there's the price. The Katali charity shop in town had this. And I sort of figured, well, if a needle is all it needs, I know I could get one. And I know my other one up there, that goes with the Marantz system, only needs a belt. So I figured, I've got a spare one for a fiver. Or, I know for a fact that even at that, though I paid a fiver for it, I could easily double that. Actually, if I bought a needle for it and got it in fully working order, I could more than double what I paid for this. So, £5 was, I'd have been stupid to walk away from it, I think. I'm not going to sell it, though. I just wanted a spare one. Just in case. It's all been electrically tested. It was done on the 25th of this month, actually. And in case you didn't know, you don't need to be a qualified electrician to pat test. There is a little course you can do. I'd love to do it just so I'm certified to do that. And, you know, perhaps I could offer my services voluntarily for charities and whatnot, and pat test there, or any electrics they get in. Although, I am going to check one thing. Only because I've had this before with a lamp that I've actually got over there. It says tested. I've opened the plug up on that lamp just out of curiosity and actually found that instead of having a 3 amp fuse in it, it had a 13. which should have been a fail. It should have had a 3 amp in it. So, what screw is actually on the end of that plug? Is that a flathead? Bloody would be, wouldn't it? 2 seconds. Good old neon screwdriver. Well, you know, it does say on the packets not to use them as a screwdriver. I do. I'd actually rather use them as a screwdriver than their intended purpose. You know, you put your finger on there, then you stick it on live things to see if it's live. I'd rather not. I'd rather use a multimeter. Because if anything goes wrong, you're going to go flying across the room with one of these. So, yeah, I don't like to use them. I don't know where I got this one from. Nope. This one is absolutely fine. There's a little bit of wire hanging out of the terminals, but nothing dangerous. Nothing to worry about either. All the terminals nice and tight. Oh, there's a little bit of... chucking bits everywhere now. And that's what the inside of a UK plug looks like, for those that don't know. Okay, my eyes are either playing tricks on me or I've got a ghost in here, because I swear I just saw something black run across the floor. Okay, so, yeah, that one's a pass. They were awake when they did this one. I was like, maybe they just didn't notice. I will say that that 13 amp fuse, at first glance, did look like a 3 amp. But, yeah. That's got the right size fuse in it. That's good. Right. So I'm going to see if I can find a needle for that. Someone that watches my videos, Mark Hyder, is looking for one of these. They're not cheap, especially a good working one. They're not cheap. You know, records are now making a comeback. You can go and buy a brand new one for 20 quid now. Weird, isn't it? That's the other reason I sort of grabbed that one when I did, because putting a needle on is a piece of cake. I'll put that needle on, I've probably got a 15, 20 quid deck there. I'm gonna zoom in a bit. I've got this lot. There is some stuff inside here. From the local junk shop that's currently cleaning out one of their shops. They've got one shop, one what they call a warehouse. Seems like they're doing away with the warehouse, so they've got everything on sale. All items are pretty much £1. So I got this whole case for £1. What it is, I'll bring this a bit closer. It's got a lot of these sort of Dremel type tool bits with it. It's not a Dremel. There is something in there as well. I only really bought it for £1, just for the bits, just to go with mine, you know. But there is something in here. I didn't look properly. I just saw all these, you know, bits in the top here, little sanding stones and whatnot. And I thought, yeah, that'll do for £1. So what have we got in here? We've got a drill bit. I don't know what that is. We've got sawdust. That looks like a stand for something. I would laugh if the tool itself is in here. Nope. That was it. Oh, this thing, whatever that is. Oh, what's under here? Ooh. I just found more stuff in the lid. Sanding discs. I don't need the Dremel tool. I've got the Dremel tool, so I'm not fussed. It's not there. Some more sanding type discs. The rest of this can go in the bin for all I care. Does that even open? Take all of these out. Yeah, take all of this off. I've actually got the other end open, just bear with me a second. It's all sort of buffer wheels and things in the other end. And a couple of wire brush things. You know what I'm actually in the mood to do? I'm in the mood to go on eBay and buy another electronics kit from China or something. I'm just in the mood to build one again. These are all sanding stones and whatnot. Ooh. Little flapper wheel thing there as well. Oh. Ow, bastard. Oh, I was just throwing one on the floor. I don't know if you can get like actual kits where you. Which are just the replacement bits. Or if you have to buy another kit, I don't know. Never really looked. Still something wrapped. Oh, it's another one of them. Double check. Little washery thing, I better take that as well. Just probably to do with that. Tool, unfortunately, but I don't matter. This bit looks empty, even if you could open it. Yeah, it's empty anyway. But I don't actually have a use for the box. Me and Mum are planning a car boot, but I don't even think I can think of anything. Anyone else would want to use on that. Here we go, this is going to be a job. Bring you back up here, around here a bit. I am keeping this toolbox. That was a pound. Well, sorry, Discord, but I want to keep the toolbox. Swear all you like. But I did put a few of the other bits in here that I wanted. So, yeah, they're doing away with the shop. I'm just going to have the main warehouse. Even at the main price, it wasn't that bad. Look, $350. I'm surprised it didn't sell for that. That was worth it for that. It's a Curva brand, so it's one of the you know, more upmarket, better brands. Even though they all do the same thing to me. It's even got the tray. What I plan to do is actually make this a bicycle repair specific toolbox. So, if I end up doing anything over at Mum's or whatnot, bike related, I'm just pick this up and go. Sometimes I go to friends to do bikes and whatnot, so. What we got? I couldn't resist. I've already got two pairs of these. Now I've got three pairs. They are one of the cheapest, lowest quality light you can imagine. Well, the brackets are. The lights themselves are fine. The brackets You sneeze near them, they're gonna snap. A saddle for a bike, a nice one at that. Not one I would use because my ass just won't like that shape, but when I'm fixing up a bike and I need a decent saddle, it cost me £1, so you know, £1 for a saddle that just needs a bit of a clean. That's all it needs, a bit of a clean. Actually, speaking of bikes, I've got someone at coming at 1 o'clock tomorrow to pick the yellow Peugeot up. So I've just got to remember, I've got to go down and take the other lights off. There's one more item in here, and it's a box. What's in the box? Something I like a lot of. Lights. Something tells me this one was actually in use. Because look at the state of it. And I think this one might actually be knackered. It feels quite heavy, like there's batteries in it. Hello. Got the original fixings in here as well. Maybe a nice eBay box for something, so. How the fudge do you get into these to change the batteries? Do we even want to look? There's no screws on the back. I'm just going to zoom you out a bit. On account of I go off screen quite a lot, so there's no screws in the back. It is bloody filthy. Doesn't even look like there's a light bulb in it, let alone anything else. Right. I don't suppose. There was a piece of paper in there. Maybe it was something. Remove the battery cover from the back of the pushlight. What fucking battery cover? Insert 4x R6/AA batteries not supplied. Observing the polarity markings inside the battery compartment. The use of alkaline batteries is recommended. Replace the battery cover. Another quality product by DSL. Never heard of them. Figured out how to do it. Got to prise the back off. Ow! You son of a. That was that was actually good timing. So it says remove the battery cover. Hammer, maybe? You know, beat the fucking shit out of it to get in there. Come on. Got me a way in. says right there, open, close. So I've got to go that way with the proxy thing. Yeah. Bang, nabbit. Well, I would open the battery cover if it would let me. Hold on. Another little sign here that says open. Ha! Howdy, howdy, ha! I'm getting somewhere. I'm in! Yeah, there is batteries in here. Ooh, it looks like I got here just in the nick of time. That one sank his batteries, that one hasn't leaked. This one had just started to, look at that. I don't know if it's coming up on camera, that had just started to leak. It hasn't actually done any damage, thankfully. No, that one's okay. Oh, and there's a little bit of leakage from the last one. Right. All it is a battery pack and a switch. Your usual sort of set up. No electronics doesn't need it, does it? There's my tool tray. There it is. Ah, good. These centre bits are actually deeper than they are on a lot of toolboxes I've had. That means I can actually put some specific smaller bike tools in there without rolling everywhere. Good. I'll do that later tonight if I get bored enough. There we go. See if these batteries are any good, shall we? 2, 3, 4. I think these energizers actually are. I'm going to find out. I don't know how good they are. I can't remember what I took them out of now. Maybe they're not. One way to find out. My meter is up here. Just quickly test them. Preferably without stabbing myself in the gut with a probe. Right. Do we have any juice? Brand new, that one. 1.55. 1.56. Yeah, these are brand new. Still plenty of juice in them. 1.56. Shall I? Just for shits and giggles. 0, 0, 0. Yep, the Sainsbury's ones are knackered. better check all four that I picked, just in case, you know. There's one dud. No, they're all testing fine. So we may have an issue with that light. Let's just open the other one. Ow. That hurt. Right, it says open. So, I'm trying to open this one, shall we? Bulb could be blown in the other one. It's probably all it is. Dead bulb, loose bulb, that would be another one. No, this one's not working either. I guarantee if I take this back off and just adjust the, tighten up the bulb, it'll probably work. But I need to get a screwdriver for that. Hang up. Got some Lego Technic. Got it. Got some money, got some scissors, I've got bloody all sorts down here. Right. Most of that can stay down there. What the fuck? You could have told me that'd come on while I was under the desk. What the hell? Okay. I actually have to say that is quite bright. That really is actually quite bright. A lot of these push lights I've had, they've been quite dim. Whoa. I'm going to leave them batteries in there then. Actually, no, because I want to get this one working, don't I? Let's open this one up. Not got the Torx bit in the end of it, I ain't. I'm having one of those days today. Longest segment of today's video, I think. Let's take care of that. I'll come closer to you. Do you want to know a secret? Tough, because I don't know any. P.S. I've got a silly mood on as well. I wouldn't tell you any secrets if I knew them anyway. They wouldn't be secret, would they? I'm actually starting to wonder if this has even got a bulb in it. I think I might have scared Nemo because he's buggered off. Yeah, I'd actually say that bulb is knackered. Well, if it isn't, it's rather black. I'll show you how we can find out. We can find out using my mirror. If it is, then... Have I pinged a screw off of this, or was there only two springs? No, there is only two mountings for springs. Oh, that's alright then. Getting a bit worried then. What we'll do, we'll pick our meter up. We will go round to diode test. Which you can also use as a continuity test. And we'll see if it beeps. If it beeps, then the bulb is good. If it doesn't beep, that means it's open circuit, and it's no good. Don't know if you can hear that, but... we are beeping really well. Okay. Right. Swap the Phillips for a flathead. Just gonna scrape that terminal down. The springs are fine. It's just that one might have a bit too much dirt on it. Now I'm gonna load these back in. That works. It didn't till I rolled the battery round, so there is still an issue with the battery connections, but at least we got to the bottom of that one. And is it me, or does that not look as bright as the other one? We won't find out. No, that is definitely not as bright as the other one, so I might just go and change that bulb for a better one anyway. Because I find that bulbs, when they start to go black like that, they start to get dim as well. Right, so I'm not going to put that together on camera because I think you're bored enough of me anyway. So I'm going to put these back in here. Oh, I know what I got these batteries out of. That metal detector that I soldered. Right. Is there actually any specific... I don't know how to do it now. Oof, bloody hell. I know how to get the back off now. There is a way to do it. I think someone had put it on wrong in the first place. Probably didn't realise because, you know, I struggled to get the damn things off. There we go. Right, I'm going to call it quits for this video then before I bore you guys to death anymore. So, thanks for watching. I've had a good day at least. I'm looking forward to some parcels arriving, I hope.
Oh, for goodness sake!
Anywho, if you liked the video, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And I will see you next time. Bye!